Friends, we are gathered in the sight of God to witness and bless the joining together of Nick and Nicole in Christian marriage. The covenant of marriage was established by God, who created us male and female for each other. With his presence and power, Jesus graced a wedding at Cana of Galilee, and in his sacrificial love, gave us the example for the love of husband and wife. Nicole and Nick come to give themselves to one another in this holy covenant. Nick and Nicole, I ask you both now, in the presence of God and these people, to declare your intention to enter into union with each other through the grace of Jesus Christ, who calls you into union with himself. Nicole, will you have Nick to be your husband, to love, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and health, forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? If you will, say, I will.
I will.
Nick, will you have Nicole to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and health, forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If you will, say, I will. Who gives this woman in marriage?
Her mother and I.
Do you who represent their families rejoice in their union and pray God's blessing upon them? If you do, say we do. For all in attendance, will you, by witnessing this marriage this day, do everything by God's grace and your power to uphold and care for Nick and Nicole in their marriage? If you will, say we will. Would you join me in prayer? God of all people, you are the true light illuminating everyone. You show us the way, the truth, and the life through Jesus Christ. You love us when we are disobedient. You sustain us with your Holy Spirit. We rejoice that you are in the midst of our lives, in the midst of this ceremony. We pray for your presence with us, and especially in this act of solemn covenant, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I want to share with you two 1 Corinthians 13. You've probably heard this before, but today I want you to pay particular attention to what it means to love. Paul the Apostle writes, "If I speak in the tongues of men or of angels, but do not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and give over my body to hardship that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. It does not boast. Love is not proud. Love does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. Love always protects, trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part and we prophesy in part. But when completeness comes, what it is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. For now we see only a reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love." My friends, the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Take a nice deep breath. You ready? Good. You made it to today. On this beautiful day, surrounded by your family and friends. Don't look at me. Remember, you're not marrying me. You're marrying each other. Who've been waiting for the two of you to make this official for quite a while now, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. When we met and talked about the tone of your wedding and what you wanted your wedding day to be like, the idea that it was to celebrate the love that you have for each other, the love for each other that led you to this point, and the love that will get you through the next 50 to 70 years as husband and wife. I want to take a minute and give you a little wisdom. First, love each other the best you can on a daily basis. I mean that. Even if it's a text from a tree stand. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Say, I love you. And show each other you love them. I tell you that because it seems simple enough now. But to love someone through the long haul is a challenge. See, after you get back from your honeymoon, you might realize, Nicole, that Nick's not perfect. And Nick, one day, many, many years to come from now, she's going to drive you crazy. However, I'm telling you both, before God, your family, your friends, that when you make that discovery, you will have to put into practice love to the 15th degree, the way that 1 Corinthians 13 tells us. You will need to practice a love that forgives, a love that does not keep records of wrongs, a love that does not anger, a love that perseveres. 1 Corinthians 13 gives us 15 attributes of love, all of which over the course of a lifetime, you will have to work on. How do you do that? Practice love to the 15th degree? Well, after today, you will no longer be an I, you're a we. Nick, Nicole's needs will be greater than your own. And Nicole, Nick's needs will be greater than your own because you are putting each other first, not demanding your way, but practicing the love that the two of you are becoming one. You can say right now, what's she talking about? It's okay. Here's the simple illustration. And for those of you that ask why the Reese's cup, here's the illustration. Really? I didn't make this up. I borrowed this one. Everyone here can attest that you are both great people on your own. Great people, right? Yeah, thank you. We can say that one of you is amazing like peanut butter, and the other one's amazing like chocolate. Both good on your own. Can we make that leap?
Yeah,
good.
Yeah.
A successful marriage takes two good things like peanut butter and chocolate and brings them together in a Reese's cup. If you practice loving each other in a way that puts the other first, you will practice being better together. You will achieve Reese's cup status. Good on your own, but even better together. So when you see a Reese's cup, I want you to remember this day and that you're better together.
It's his favorite.
I didn't even know that. Well, this works then. Today, you are declaring to each other, and in a minute, you will take the vows and exchange the rings that says you have found the one who does not complete you, but rather makes you the best possible you can be, committing to love each other to the 15th degree. Also, allow Jesus to be the center of your marriage, not just on days when you are driving each other crazy, and I know that won't happen, but on the ordinary. So on the ordinary days, love each other as much as you do today. And your first anniversary, your 10th anniversary, and your 50th anniversary. When someone asks you what your secret is, you can tell them a Reese's cup reminds us we are better together. And Jesus, who has loved us more perfectly, is the center of our marriage. Not perfect, better together. We have love to the 15th degree each and every day, and that's made all the difference. That's our hope. That's our prayer as you begin life as husband and wife. Would you join me in prayer? Gracious God, we just thank you once again for bringing Nick and Nicole together. We thank you that they have found each other and that you are with them as they begin their life as husband and wife. Father, as we prepare to move into the vows and the rings, we just pray for your spirit to fill them and to continue to bless them today and every day hereafter. For this we ask in the name of Jesus. Amen. Ready, Nick?
Mm-hmm.
Repeat after me. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Nick.
I, Nick.
Take you.
Take you.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Fantastic. Ready? In the name of God.
In the name of God.
Move a little closer to him. I, Nicole. Take you to be my husband.
Take you to be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Fantastic. The rings.
So funny. This is funny.
Thank you. Perfect. He did great. These rings are an outward symbol and a visible sign of an onward and spiritual grace, signifying to us the union between Jesus and his church. These rings are the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to us the uniting of Nicole and Nick in holy marriage. Let me put it very simply. When you see these rings for the rest of the world, you will declare that you are done shopping. You have found the one you'll want to be with for the rest of your life. And I will tell you, for Nick, especially for the guy, it's always challenging because it'll be irritating for a while. It'll get banged up and bruised. My husband's wedding ring is an oval. And I ask him all the time, please get it fixed. And he says, no, it's just that way because it's the story of your marriage, right? Join with me in prayer. Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may live in your peace and continue in your favor all the days of our life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. All right, nice and easy.
Halfway, right?
Halfway, perfect. Ready? Halfway. Nicole, perfect. Repeat after me. Mm-hmm. Nicole.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow. With all that I am.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
Son.
And Holy Spirit.
Amen. Very nice.
Here's
ready?
Yeah.
Nick.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
Son.
And Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Oh, you guys were so nice. Okay, go ahead and turn outward. Yeah, turn off. Perfect.
For as much as Nicole and Nick have consented together in wedlock and have witnessed the same before God in this company, have pledged their faith to each other, and have declared the same by the joining of hands and giving and receiving of rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife, together in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. My friends, would you pray with me? O God, you have consecrated the covenant of marriage, that in it is represented the covenant between Christ and his church. Send your blessing upon Nicole and Nick, that they may surely keep their marriage covenant, and so grow in love and godliness together, that their home may be a haven of blessing and peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Okay, don't be scared now. This is that weird part.
The Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord graciously with his favor look upon you, and so fill you with love, that you may so love together in this life, that in the world to come, you may have life everlasting. Amen. Take two steps forward. Grab your flowers. Ladies and gentlemen, I announce that Nicole and Nick are husband and wife. Nick, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Nick Geraci.
Thank you. still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? Darling, I will be loving you till we're 70. And baby, my heart could still fall as hard at 23.
Until you find the window, if it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want until your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry no cross. Come on and twist around, yeah, baby, twist around, yeah, just like this.
Bye-bye. Now watch me whip,
hey.
Now watch me nae-nae.
Okay.
Now watch me whip, watch me nae-nae.
Why me do
now
it?
Now watch me whip,
kill it.
Watch me nae-nae.
Okay.
Now watch me whip, watch me nae-nae.
Can you do
now
it?
Now watch me, ooh, watch
yeah.
me, watch me, ooh, watch
yeah.
me, watch me, ooh, watch
yeah.
me, watch me.
To the sea, to the sea, to the open arms of the sea. Wait for me, wait for me. I'll be coming home. Wait for me.
Everybody clap your hands. Come on, y'all. Check it out, y'all.
Teach you, teach you, teach you, I'll teach you the electric.